Welcome to the Victor Tran animation tutorial. A few of you guys have requested a series on how I do my animations. Take a look at the card for an example of one of my animations if you haven't seen it yet. On screen is what I will be using to create animations. To follow this tutorial, you will need PowerPoint 2007 or later. I, personally, am using PowerPoint 2016. You will also need KDE and Live to follow the video editing sections of these tutorials. Currently, KDE and Live is only available for Linux, but this may change soon. If you don't want to install KDE and Live, or if you don't have Linux installed, you can probably use any video editor, but you won't be able to follow on with me. Let's go through the interface of PowerPoint 2016. Here, I have a new slide with some objects that we can animate. To add a new object, simply find the Shapes option inside the ribbon. Choose a shape and draw it onto the slide. To keep the ratio of the new shape constant, you can hold the Control key down as you draw the shape. To help you see what keys I'm holding down, there's an overlay in the bottom left corner showing which keys I'm pressing. To move a shape, simply drag it around. To restrict the shape to moving in the cardinal directions, hold down the Shift key. To place a copy of the shape, hold down the Control key while dragging around, and then drop the shape as you hold the key. This will create a copy of the shape. To place a shape in a precise position without PowerPoint messing around with it, hold down the Alt key. Notice how the guides are not appearing when I hold down the Alt key. These modifier keys can also be held down at the same time to activate their effects together. On the ribbon, there is an Animations tab. This is where all the animations are done. To animate a shape, click on it, choose Add Animation, and select an animation. There are four types of animation in PowerPoint. Entrance effects make an object appear. Emphasis effects make a shape stand out to the viewer. Exit effects make an object disappear. And a motion path moves a shape around on the screen. If you'd like to look for more effects, there are extra effects down at the bottom. Click on More Effects to open up a window with all the available effects. Select an effect, then hit OK when you're happy with that effect. To see your effect, just press F5 to start the slideshow, and then click the mouse, or press the right arrow on the keyboard. You can add more effects to the same shape, and to different shapes. Each effect that you add will take effect the next time you progress the slides. For example, here I'm adding a pulse effect to the circle, and then a flyout effect to the square. When I start the slideshow, the square animates in first, followed by the circle pulsing, and then the square animating out. In the ribbon, there is an Animation Pane button that lets you sequence your animations. You'll notice that all the animations that we have added to the slide is on there. To reorder an animation, simply drag the animation into the order in which you want them to play. For example, if I prefer the circle to pulse first, I can drag the circle's animation to the top. That way, when I start the slideshow, the circle will pulse, and then the square will animate. You can also change some animation settings. For example, if I want the square to fly in from the top, I can click on the square's entrance animation, and then in the ribbon, I can click on Effect Options and choose a direction to animate the square in. Each animation has different options, and some animations, like the pulse animation on the circle, don't have options at all. For advanced animation settings, I can click on the down arrow next to the corresponding animation on the animation pane, and choose Effect Options from there. Just like the basic settings, some animations will have different settings. Feel free to experiment with these settings to get the results that you want. For the square, I'm just going to set Smooth End all the way to the maximum value, so the square decreases speed in a natural fashion. This concludes part 1 on my series on how I do my animations. If you'd like to download the PowerPoint file that was created by following these instructions, there's a clicky thing in the box down below where you can find it. The next video in this series that I plan to make will be about sequencing your animations, how to automatically run your animations, setting timings, and more. thanks for watching, everyone.